insane liberal bail laws. Taylor Swift's latest alleged stalker is back behind bars, but only after getting arrested 3 times in just 5 days. I agree with the internet. He's had a wild week with Swift stalking here in New York City. It all began Saturday afternoon. He crow got arrested while trying to enter Taylor's residence. By Monday, Christian Crowe's back on the streets, and he returned to Swift's place. Cops charged him with harassment and stalking, and he was in court on Wednesday to face those charges, but 10 minutes after he walked out, Crowe was spotted dumpster diving near Taylor's house and arrested again. But he says it's all just one big misunderstanding. Nothing is really all that serious. I mean, we've got a DA who barely prosecutes crime. We've got bail laws that, you know, you commit violent crime. Don't worry about it. You can come back if we can, you know, interfere with your schedule next month. Can you make it back? Look, I feel terrible about this. This guy had bench warrants from 2017. He had cases from 2023. He had three days, I think it was Saturday, Monday, and then Wednesday. And I'll tell you, the only reason he's in jail is because they arrested him on a contempt of court. When you violate a court order, the court gets their backup and says, we're going to keep you in jail.
I apologize about the annoying news in the background. That is my father.
Well, what are they teaching in Seattle, if anything? What? That's besides the point. She,
the writer says, love doesn't just sit there.
Yeah, well, for him, love, you know, it violates and stalks. And unfortunately, many, many women are killed in spite of the fact that they're stalked. In domestic violence cases, something like 20% of the women are killed again for who they're going to be. Stalking charges are murdered. 75% of the women in a murdered in a relationship are murdered once they say I'm leaving.